Welcome back to this episode of Wiccan's Wicked Reptiles. On this week's episode, I'm going to teach you how to make an incubator for your reptile eggs out of nothing more than three pieces of material and a little bit of tape. Stick around. I think one of the largest barriers to entry with breeding reptiles is the fact that an incubator costs a lot of money. It costs a lot of money to get going and to get started. You have to get all the animals, the setups, and everything like that. But what if I told you the incubator is going to be the cheapest part? See, the difference between using an old wine fridge or a cooler that you make yourself with a little bit of heat tape and a thermostat and something that you buy at a reptile store is negligible. It's almost zero. Basically, you're paying for the name and the construction and the aesthetic of it more than anything else. But if what you want is just a functional piece of equipment to incubate your reptile eggs, this is what you want right here. Just one old cooler, a thermostat, and a little bit of heat tape. So let's get into the construction and let's teach you how to make this thing. The three items that you're going to need to make your incubator is an old cooler or a new cooler or whatever. You don't even going to ruin your cooler, so if you want to use one that you borrow from your parents or whatever, you're okay. You're not gonna drill holes through it. You can use it again as a cooler when you're done. Or if a lot of people like to do is use the coolers that you can buy at the dollar store, just the $4 styrofoam coolers, you can use those as well. I just think that these hold the heat a little bit better, hold the humidity, and it's what my choice was, and that's what I had laying around in my garage. The second thing is heat tape or heat cord or something like that that produces heat. You could also use a heat mat if you wanted as well. Also, you're going to need a thermostat, and the thermostat is really important because that's what controls your temperature. If you just stuck some wires to some heat tape and plugged it into the wall, well, your incubator is probably going to be 120 degrees, and you're not going to incubate anything at that temperature. So let's go ahead and take a look inside at the other things that I've used besides the three essential things that we've looked at. Also, like you'll see here, you're going to see this little tray. It's a black tray, kind of like what you use for seedlings. You plant the seeds in here before you put them in the garden. I've drilled a bunch of holes through so that the heat can go through, and what's underneath the tray is a bunch of water bottles. And the reason that I do that is because if for whatever reason the thermostat shut off, there's a power outage, the bottles of water are going to be the temperature of the inside of the incubator. Or for videos like this, where I've unplugged it for 20 minutes so I can do the video, it's going to hold on to that heat, and it's going to continue to put that heat into the incubator as well. So you're not unplugging it and then all of a sudden all the heat goes away. You have something there that's holding the heat. It's kind of a safeguard that'll hold you for an hour or two while you're working on getting heat packs or the heat turned back on in your house. And wrapped not only underneath the water bottles and the tray, but over top and throughout the entire enclosure, the entire incubator, I should say, is a heat cord. I just use heat cord because that's what I had at the time. It was before I even had my racks built, so I didn't have any heat tape like this, which is probably your best bet, just because it's a lot thicker. It provides just a more surface area for the heat to be radiating throughout the entire incubator. Also, I've got here the thermostat, and the thermostat, it's not made for reptiles. It's actually a jumpstart thermostat. It's made for heat mats to go underneath of trays for seedlings, for plants. That's what it's made for. But it does the same job. It'll go all the way up to 115 degrees, which you'll never need. And it goes as low as 68 degrees, which also you'll never need. And the idea that I think is a great idea as well is not only with your thermostat, which you're gonna see here is showing the heat, showing the temperature that it's at. You can adjust it, of course. And I think it's gonna be pretty accurate. But if you want a safeguard, you can always use a different thermometer. You can go inside with a heat gun so you can see the surface temperature of everything, including your eggs. But also just having a second thermometer. Mine, the battery just burned out, but that's what I always do, just to make sure that they read the same temperature. It's just basically a safeguard to protect yourself against a malfunction in your thermostat. If your thermostat goes bad, well, so do your eggs, and that's not what you want to do. And I mentioned earlier in the video that you're not going to need to ruin the cooler. And the way that you get the cords inside without actually drilling holes into it, which would ruin your cooler, is you use the drainage hole. So in every cooler that you have that's not made of styrofoam, that's meant to be reused, you have a little plug that you can go ahead and drain all the water out of once the ice melts. So basically, to get the cords inside, you just fish them through, and you're gonna have three cords. You're gonna have the probe for the actual thermostat, you're going to have the heat cord or heat tape or whatever it is, the cord that attaches to your heat source that goes inside of there. And then if you choose to use a second thermometer just as a safeguard, like I mentioned earlier, that cord's going to go in there as well. Plenty of space. In fact, you're going to need to plug up the hole so that you don't get a bunch of air exchange in and out. Here's how you do that. What I used is just regular felt. You can use even just tape would be fine, or a piece of an old rag or whatever. I used a piece of felt, I jammed it in there, and I duct taped it all so that the cords don't move in and out anymore. They're secure, and also you're not going to have heat exchange, any air exchange in and out of the cooler. The only air exchange that you want is when you open the lid once every couple days in order to give your eggs a chance to breathe. So once you fish your cords inside, what you want to do is you want to give it an even dispersion of temperature. I made that word up. It sounds good though. So you take your cord and wrap it all the way around. You want it high, you want it low, you want it basically everywhere except for the lid, because you're going to need to open it, so that you have the most amount of heat and the most amount of area, and it's very even throughout, because otherwise you're going to need a fan, which is what I don't like about larger incubators, is that you need a fan to circulate the temperature. And something this small, you don't need a fan. The temperature is going to be pretty static, it's going to be pretty even throughout, and you're going to be good to go. See the end of the heat tape here, the end of the heat cord here, and it's wrapped throughout. And then you're right here, you're going to see the probe, which is going to be the probe for your thermostat, and that's going to see where the temperature's at. And then of course it'll bump it up or it'll stop working, so that the temperature is exactly where you need it to be. Of course it can't cool it down, so if you're incubating eggs at 83 degrees, don't keep it in an 85 degree room. That's basically the idea. But if you're keeping it in a cooler room than what the temperature needs to be, then your heat tape will heat it up until it is at the temperature that it needs to be at, and then the thermostat will shut off until it is no longer. It's just kind of like the thermostat in your house, exactly the same. So that's basically it. You get your old cooler, you stick three cords in there, put a bunch of bottles of water underneath and a tray on top, and that's it. You wait for the eggs to come, and then you take care of your eggs. And if you want to know how to do that, well, got a video for you right here. Thank you very much for coming back and watching this episode of Wiccan's Wicked Reptiles. We do videos every Monday and every Thursday, and that means that I'll see you on Monday.